Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and welcome back to the next video. And this is the second video in the series of videos on the cancer. In the last video, I've told you that this term cancer is derived from the Latin meaning crab, as the crab is famous for its stubbornness. Is this cancer hard to treat? I told you about the neoplasm, that neoplasm or tumor is an abnormal mass of tissue as a result of abnormal growth or division of the cell. Then we defined the tumor or the neoplasm, and we do discuss about the limitations of the definition. We talked about the neoplasia and the hyperplasia, that both of these are the overgrowth or the excessive cell division, but neoplasia is an abnormal cell division, but the hyperplasia is normal excessive cell division. Then we discussed about the components of the tumor, that there are two components of the tumor. One is known as the parenchyma, which are the actual neoplastic cells, and the stroma, which are actually the supportive tissue. And I've told you that for the normal creature, the tumor can be based on the clinical course, which is benign in tumor, and it can also be based on the tissue of origin. We discussed about the benign tumor, how the nomenclature of the benign tumor is there, that we are using the oma suffix to represent the benign tumor, and the tissue of origin is actually before that particular suffix. For example, when you talk about the fibroma, so this oma suffix is actually showing you that this is the benign tumor, and this fibro is actually showing you the tissue of origin. So the fibroma, that would be the benign tumor of the fibroblast cells. And the chondroma, that will be the benign tumor of the cartilage, and the osteoma will be the benign tumor of the osteoblast. We discussed about the nomenclature of the epithelial origin, and how the benign tumors of the epithelial origin, they are named, and we said that the adenoma is actually a term that is used for the benign tumor of the glands. We talked about the villous adenoma, about the papilloma, and then we talked about some of the exceptions. Now, in this particular video, I want to focus on the nomenclature of the malignant tumor. And this malignant tumor is actually the cancer. So when we use the term cancer, we are actually referring to the malignant tumor, and we are not referring to the benign tumor. I told you that the benign tumor, most of the time, they are harmless. But in certain conditions, like if the benign tumor is made in the neurons or in the windpipe, they can be harmful. But in most of the cases, they are harmless. But the malignant tumor, they are always harmful. When you talk about the nomenclature of the malignant tumor, so we use the suffix sarcoma. The suffix sarcoma is actually added to the tissue of origin to represent a malignant tumor. For example, in case of the mesenchymal origin malignant tumors, fibrosarcoma, that will be the malignant tumor of the fibroblast cells. So if you see my last video, I've told you that if the tumor of the fibroblast origin, if that is benign in nature, we called it is the fibroma, because we use the suffix oma for the benign tumor. But if the same fibroblast cells have got the malignant tumor, we will be using this term fibrosarcoma. So the fibroma will be the benign tumor of the fibroblast cells. Fibrosarcoma will be the malignant tumors of the fibroblast cells. Similarly, the chondroma, we discussed that in the last video, that chondroma is the benign tumor of the chondrocytes. But the chondrosarcoma, that will be the malignant tumor of the cartilage cells. When you talk about the nomenclature of the epithelial origin for the malignant tumors, we actually use the suffix carcinoma. For example, if you remember, I've told you that if the there is a benign tumor in a gland, that will be known as the adenoma. So the oma was actually representing the benign tumor of the benign tumor of the glands, but if you add the suffix carcinoma with the adeno, that will be representing the malignant tumor of the gland. So adenocarcinoma, that will be the malignant tissue of the gland. There are also some other nomenclatures that are used for tumors, and one of the important nomenclature is known as the mixed tumors. Now, when you talk about these mixed tumors, the tumors in which the neoplastic cells have more than one morphological pattern. Now, what I mean by that these neoplastic cells have got more than one morphological pattern. One of the important examples of the mixed tumor is the pleomorphic adenoma of the parotid gland. This is one of the important examples of the mixed tumors. When we use this term pleomorphic, this pleomorphism actually refers to the variability in the size and shape of the cell or their nuclei. And when you talk specifically about the microbiology, so the pleomorphism, there will be the ability of some bacteria to alter their shape or size in response to the environmental conditions. So with respect to the tumors, the pleomorphic will mean that there will be neoplastic cells, but those neoplastic cells, they will be pleomorphic in nature. They will be of more than one morphology. So the pleomorphic adenoma of the parotid gland means that the adenoma of the parotid gland, they will be having more than one morphological pattern, or they will be derived from more than one different kind of the cells. Now the parotid glands, they are either of a pair of large salivary glands situated in front of each ear. For example, if you see, this is the location of the parotid gland. So when there is a mixed tumor in the parotid gland, that is actually known as the pleomorphic adenoma of the parotid gland. It is called as adenoma because this is the benign tumor of the gland. In this particular case, this is the parotid gland. Now, why we call it is the neoplastic, because if you observe the pleomorphic adenoma of the parotid gland, you will see that the neoplastic cells, they will be of the epithelial origin as well as the cartilage origin. So in the benign tumor of the parotid gland, you will be seeing that the neoplastic cells, some of them, they will be derived from the epithelial origin, and some of them, they will be derived from the cartilage, from the chondrocytes. If this means that if they are derived from different cells, their shape, that will be different from each other. Therefore, we call this is the pleomorphic. Now, both of these different morphological structures are, however, derived from the same germ layer, ectoderm in this particular case. So we say that the epithelial origin cells and the cartilage cell, they are derived from the ectoderm, but their shapes, they will be different from each other. Now, why I'm telling you this, that both of these different morphological structures are derived from the same germ layer. This is to differentiate it from the other type of the nomenclature, which is known as the teratoma. Now, in teratoma, again, there are different morphological structures, just like the mixed tumors. But the difference between the mixed tumor and the teratoma is that in the teratoma, the different morphological structures are derived from different germ layers. Sometimes all of the three germ layers are involved. For example, when you talk about the cancer in ovary or the testes, that means all of the three germ layers, the ectoderm, the mesoderm, and the endoderm cells, they will be involved in the formation of the neoplastic cells. So the major difference between the teratoma and the mixed tumor will be that both of them, they have got different morphological structures, different neoplastic cells, but in mixed tumors, these different morphological structures are derived from the same germ layer, and in case of the teratoma, they will be derived from a different germ layer. Now, the nomenclature of the cancer cells of the cancers of the blood cell, that is a little bit different, because the cancer of the blood cells, they are known as the leukemia, and the cancer of the lymph nodes, that is known as the lymphoma. And the leukemia and the lymphoma, they are always malignant, and the leukemia and the lymphoma, they do not follow any of the pattern that we discussed, that the nomenclature we discussed for the benign tumors, for the malignant tumor, for the teratoma, or the mixed tumor. In the next video, I'll be focusing on the characteristics of the benign and the malignant tumor. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and share it with your friends.